Coming up during the next hour of the show, another play of this week's Record of the Week from Rosalind. Your love song messages are at 10.15. Pens and scorecards at the ready. 10 to the top is hit at 10.30. And more of your childhood habits and pastimes that you just can't give up. It's Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app on your smart speaker and 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 10 o'clock. This is Justine Green. In the past hour, the boss of one of the UK's largest business groups, the CBI, has been fired after an investigation into complaints about his conduct at work. Tony Danker will leave the group with immediate effect. He apologised in the wake of the allegations over his behaviour towards a female employee. He said any offence he caused was unintentional. Our business correspondent Emma Simpson is following developments.
He has been under investigation since complaints of workplace misconduct was made against him. First complaint in January, then further complaints came to light. Then after fairly swift investigation, we have the results. The investigation has determined that his own conduct fell short of that expected of the Director General.
Plans have been announced to offer vaping starter kits to help people in England quit smoking. Health officials say 9% of pregnant women still smoke, so mothers-to-be will be offered up to £400 in vouchers to give up. Junior doctors in England have begun a four-day strike in a row over pay. NHS bosses have said it will be the most disruptive industrial action in the history of the health service. More than a quarter of a million appointments are due to be cancelled. Kevin McGee is the CEO of NHS Lancashire Teaching Hospitals, which looks after hospitals in Preston and Chorley. He says the trust is prioritising emergency care.
Our services are safe and our hospital is covered. But it's massive disruption that's being caused to patients and patient flow. And of course, although this is a four-day strike, what we're having to do is to change the job plans and the rotas of our senior consultant. So this will take into next week to recalibrate the organisation and get the flow back into the organisation.
President Biden will arrive in Northern Ireland this evening to mark the 25th anniversary of the Good Friday Agreement. The deal brought the Troubles largely to an end. Hollywood Bowl has reported record revenues over the past 6 months as people hunt for cheap activities because of cost of living pressures. The bowling operators said it made £111 million in the 6 months to March. Sales were also driven up as the group opened two new centres to add to their 69 venues in the UK. A lifeboat house on the North Norfolk coast is housing three National Trust rangers for 8 months so they can monitor one of the UK's rarest seabirds through the breeding season. The charity says the wild landscape at Blakeney Point is ideal for little terns, but the population has dropped by 40% since the 80s. Tori Backham from the Norfolk Wildlife Trust says the location means the birds need special protection.
They nest on the ground so that the eggs, as you can imagine, are perfectly camouflaged, which is great for predators, but not so great when we've got people walking on the beach. And in Norfolk, our beaches are particularly busy, so it's really important that we educate people about the birds and let them know that they're here.
And that's the BBC News. It's 3 minutes past 10.
Thank you, Justine. Talking about childhood habits, what do you still have?
I still have roller skates. Well, I mean, you know, 39 years ago, it started off as, you know, the 80s roller boots with rainbows up the side. I mean, now there's sleek, chic roller blades.
Yes.
But, you know, still skating and plans to return to the roller disco.
Good girl. And I hope you skated in today.
Not today. It was a bit early.
Okay. Thank you. Gary Davies.
Listen live on the BBC Sounds app.
Gary Davis, ooh, Gary Davis, ooh, Gary Davis on your radio.
One, two,